Hello Reapers, my name is Seth and we are back here for some more Trove. I'm recording this on the test server. The test server is offline, but I was making sure that I ended up recording this video to all of you folks so that you know when the Trove Heroes update ends up coming out, what's going to actually end up happening to the Draco. Because everybody's always asking me whenever I was doing streams on the test server, people were always wondering what is actually going on with the Draco, because lots of people love the character, but it was pretty much one of the weakest characters in the game. And now I'm very, very happy to report that this character is not only viable for U9, just because of how quickly you're going to be able to clear dungeons and stuff. You're not going to be the fastest. You know, you're not going to have the insane amount of movement speed or anything like that, but we will talk about a build for that in today's video. But Shadow Towers, more specifically, is where this character absolutely shines, because the big, big changes that they're going to be making to the character have to do with not only just his basic attack is going to have a bigger arc, you're going to have overall a little bit more damage, you're going to have more health regen when you're in your ultimate ability, but what single-handedly makes this character that much stronger is the fact that your subclass ability is going to end up guaranteeing you 100% chance to actually spawn a baby ally, because previously it was random whether or not it would spawn. And I mean, I'm not a fan of randomness when it comes to abilities in games, because that's just bad game design as far as I'm concerned. I think that a lot of the characters should end up getting a rework where it 100% spawns, like the Chloromancer might end up being a late game character if you would actually be able to spawn your cactus plant all the time instead of it being completely random. But your burnt offerings changed a little bit as well. They're actually going to be on a 6-second timer before they end up exploding. And if you throw one down and damage it, you're only going to have to damage it twice before it ends up exploding as well. And thus you're going to end up summoning more minions. As far as I remember, I think you can summon a total of 6 babies. Let me actually see right here. This is 6. There we go. Yeah, so you can only summon 6 babies at a time. So, you know, with the way that these guys end up working, where they're going to just slowly end up dying over time in general, they actually don't take that much damage from enemies in the first place. So usually they will end up dying at a very, very steady pace where you're just going to want to be casting your number one like over and over and over again. And because of it, energy regen becomes very, very important. As you can see, I actually don't have energy regen on my ring, but I would actually recommend that you have a magic damage and energy regen ring, and then have energy regen on your weapon as well. This is where I personally would, rather than crit damage, have energy regen as the second stat, or maybe movement speed, because I would like to be able to have energy regen as my second stat, because it's essential to the character, and then have movement speed as the fourth stat, so that I could roll that to crit damage anytime I needed to go into Shadow Towers, or I could keep the movement speed if I was just doing U9 farming and stuff. But I guess at the same time, you don't necessarily need the energy regen when you're out farming, because you're going to kill a dungeon boss before you even get to cast a bomb in the first place. And then for the rest of your gear, you know, crit damage second stat, because attack speed you're not going to need at all. And then movement speed as the fourth stat is going to end up being ideal. For the ally, you're using the Chronomancer Cubesly, because that's going to end up giving you reduced cooldown by 25%. If you're out farming, you're going to use the Prefect Penguin, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. For the emblems, as well as the flask, I always just use Deathifying. You know, I'm a big fan of it. It's just the casual go-to vial of the entire game. But then in combination, I actually use Unyielding Emblem, which ends up giving you brief invulnerability. And this is going to be essential to actually using this character in Shadow Tower, because you're going to be right down in it with everybody. And if you're not using Unyielding, you're just going to be draining pots left and right. However, the big deal about this character and how you actually play it now is a little bit different, because your little dino babies or your Draco babies are going to actually take aggro from enemies. So what you're trying to essentially do is have one of these guys down fighting an enemy, and you're going to want to stay behind the enemy at all times, because the enemy's going to keep on doing attacks towards the Draco baby, and if you're caught in the way of that, you're going to end up taking damage even though it's not necessarily trying to attack you. You know what I mean? And then, of course, just Arcane Emblem so that you have that extra damage. For the gems, I do not have ideal gems. I actually have ideal as far as just my lesser and empower gems, but my class gem ability absolutely sucks. Let me actually just show you this right here. What you're going to try and get ideally as you end up fully augmenting your gems and leveling them up is you want to have magic damage, crit damage, and crit hit on all of your gems. And you're going to want to try and get for your empowered gems anyways, magic damage to have two squares to it, one square to crit damage, and no squares on any of your gems to the crit hit. And then three of your lesser gems, you're going to want to have crit damage, have two squares, and then the other three are just going to end up being magic damage, two square, crit damage, one square, et cetera, et cetera. But you can see with the class gem ability right here, I actually have, it's not fully augmented. I've only got two squares. I don't even have an extra square into the crit damage. So essentially, this character would actually be that much stronger. So keep that in mind, because of course, when it comes to the live server, I'm going to try and go for a perfect gem and stuff like that. But let's hop into Ultra Towers right here. I do want to confirm, even though we're not going to try it out today, that you can actually handle pretty much all the bosses in the game. You can actually get very close to soloing Dread as well. I think you actually could do it with the Draco, so long as you're using Prowling Shadow. That's what Merc was telling me. He was testing it out, and he got really, really close to beating the boss, but he had to have a life-stealing ally so that he ended up keeping his health, because eventually you just slowly run out of potions anyways. That's just kind of how Dread is. But also with Dread, as long as you stay in his face, he's not going to use his long-range auto-attacks and just take one potion each time. But in either case, this is going to be the prime example right here, guys, because Ultra Daughter of the Moon, this right here, these enemies in a dungeon, not an arena, because arena enemies are going to be weaker, while dungeon enemies, this is the strongest enemies in the entire game right here. And as the Draco, we're just going to end up mopping the floor with them. Like, seriously, look at the amount of damage that we got going on here. But the biggest question you're probably sitting there asking is this character and, going to end up being better than the Gunslinger? Now, there's a two-sided argument to that, because the Gunslinger is still going to end up being the highest DPS in the game as far as burst damage is concerned, whereas this character, I was testing it out, I was trying things out, I was calculating on the live server, because as I'm testing this character out on the test server, I have all of my Gunslinger gems swapped over to the Draco, whereas on the live server, I still have all of my gems on my Gunslinger, because obviously this rework hasn't been put into the game yet, and I was actually testing it out and trying, the different numbers, just looking at the raw damage and calculating it and all that stuff, and near as I can tell, I think that the Draco actually does more damage. It's just kind of slow over time damage. So I would actually say that the Draco is either tied or even better than the Gunslinger for normal Shadow Tower arenas like we're doing right here, where you're just fighting normal enemies and stuff. Most of all, because that extra survivability that you actually have as the Draco, and he's just like, he's much easier to build than the Gunslinger, because you don't necessarily have to have 100% crit hit, and you're going to have that much more survivability just because, like you see right here, my Dino Babies are taking all of the aggro, so I'm barely going through any of my flasks, even though I have Unyielding saving my butt, I'm barely going through my flasks. And they also ended up changing it too, so that you can use your Dino Baby, like your right click, twice as fast. I'm still not in the habit of even using that ability very often. And rest assured, you could actually just sit here and try to tank out these guys as well, because the Draco actually has a lot of life regen when you're in your ultimate. But more so, it just makes you very tanky. I don't know whether it just gives you extra health or something, but generally speaking, you're just a lot stronger when you're in your ultimate form, and you're going to end up doing that much more damage as well. And you can see, 13 pots to spare. Like, we're doing just fine. And that's the whole thing, too, is recently I've actually been using the Knight subclass ability for most of my characters because of that extra 6 flask capacity. To me, is longer lifespan versus trying to get more damage out of using the Lunar Lancer subclass. And the Lunar Lancer subclass ability is good. It makes you powerful on most characters. It's actually kind of the go-to strongest subclass ability in the game, but doesn't necessarily work on the Draco, because even though you are going to end up having more attack speed, a little bit more movement speed and stuff like that, you aren't going to end up seeing any advantage to the attack speed, right? Like, you're just going to end up getting raw damage from it rather than actually getting any attack speed. So I always just go for the Knight subclass ability because of the fact that it gives us more flask capacity. So anyways, let me hop back into the club world and randomize some of the stats on my gear. And let's go try this guy out in U9, because I think that was already a really good example to show you just how crazy easy it is to actually farm Shadow Towers with this guy. And as far as stats are concerned, the absolute ideal, though not entirely required is you're gonna want to go for 125,000 physical or magic damage, not physical. 100% crit hit if you can muster it, and then 1,700 crit damage. Which I would have those stats if my class gem ability was better, and I ended up having it fully augmented. Right. However, if you're just trying to build the character, you know, outright, and you can't actually afford any of that stuff, you're gonna slowly augment your gems over time. You can go for 100,000 magic damage ideally, and then maybe 1,400 crit damage, and you can get away with 75% to 80% crit hit because of the fact that you're damaging like at a constant stream, that crit hit is not going to matter as much as it does with slower moving characters where the crit hit, like you have to have it trigger like every single time. That said, you still want to get like the ideal stats of having 100% crit hit, but it's not entirely required is what I'm saying for this character to even be strong. So we got a couple options for building the Draco for U9. For the most part, you're just going to be building at DPS, but then you're going to be focusing on movement speed because that's just pretty much the end game of Trove. So I've swapped movement speed onto all of my gear, and you can see that we're actually that much faster while we're walking around. Ideally for your gems, you're going to want a pyro disc. I unfortunately don't have any pyro discs on the test server as I'm recording this right now, but when it comes to the live server, I ended up getting really lucky with a couple pyro discs, so, you know, I'm going to be able to actually try those out to make more speed builds and stuff like that, right? But for the most part, you're going to want to go for pyro disc in U9 if you can, because it's going to give you increased movement speed. And then when you cast your ult, you're going to have a little bit, it's not much, but a little bit more movement speed as well, right? And then Prefect Penguin is going to operate the same as the Raptor Berserker, where you can see after you kill an enemy, you're going to end up having more movement speed. And then you're going to want to swap your one of your emblems for Trailblazing, swap out the Chrono emblem, because you're not going to end up needing that necessarily. And again, this is where you want to have that ideal, like, or not Chrono emblem, I mean swap out the unyielding, right? Because then you're going to end up having the Trailblazing, which is going to make you that much faster. And then the other option that you could end up doing is swapping the vial over to the Conjurer's vial, which means that it's going to end up recharging a flask if you trigger magic finds. So that's pretty much only for people that are at the end game or using Patron. And then you would actually have to swap your Arcane emblem out for like the unyielding, because you're not gonna have death defying, so you're not going to end up like being able to survive very well. So what you're trying to do is just go into a dungeon, and as you can see, we just clear these guys like so fast, and that was without a flask. Like, we didn't even need to use a flask or anything, and we most certainly didn't need to use our Draco babies. But I'm gonna keep tagging enemies every now and then while we're out farming so that we can end up triggering our Prefect Penguin's movement speed buff, because that's going to end up being what you're going for. That's why you want to make sure that you're always killing something within that cooldown range. And then again, you know, as you can see, we're already doing enough damage that we don't necessarily even have to use the Arcane Vial. So I'm going to just show you this right here. If we swap on over to the Conjurers and use Unyielding, it does mean that you got to play the character a little bit different. Usually I'm pretty lazy as far as how I play Trove. You know, I just kind of go for things, and I just play the game very, very casually and just grind it for hours. Not to mention, if you're up all night, you might forget to use a potion and stuff like that. You know how it goes, right, guys, if you've ended up grinding this game for like way, way too long. But the reason that I'm saying that, though, is because I just like to stick to death defying. It's just my go-to. It's super duper easy play style, right? So if you end up using this other vial, it means that you're not gonna have the survivability of being absolutely invincible when you get a hit off from an enemy. So you gotta cast a pot every time you end up going into combat, pretty much. But so long as you're actually, you know, so long as you're going to end up getting a dungeon chest and you have enough magic find that you're going to guarantee trigger it every single time, it does mean that you are going to end up getting a flask back more often than not. And if you have magic find triggering a couple times, it does mean that you're going to end up getting a couple flasks back. And then again, I always like to use the Knight subclass ability just because it gives extra vials, which to me is like longer grinding, right? Like that's kind of what that means to me, and that's why I like to go for it. But if you really, really want to, like, let's try it right here where we swap over to the Lunar Lancer subclass ability, because we're gonna get that increased movement speed so long as we end up actually triggering lunacy mode, because we're not really going for damage or anything like that, because it's just U9. So obviously the character is going to end up working a little bit differently. Now, another thing too to keep in mind is recipe dungeons are going to be an absolute trick for you. You don't want to go into them like I just did, like a scrub, because that's going to end up, you're not going to have any chances of triggering magic find, unfortunately, if you're going into one of those dungeons, right? Because you're going to end up getting a scroll rather than actually triggering a dungeon chest, which is going to end up actually being what you want to get that extra item that we just got out of it right there, right? So, I mean, that's pretty much all I really got to say about the characters. I'm really, really excited, though, at the fact that they ended up making it completely viable, not only for just, like, U9 farming, but also just for Shadow Towers. And again, if we had a Pyro Disc, we would be that much faster. And while we're not, like, the fastest character in the game as far as just grinding is concerned, you can main the character. That's kind of why I wanted to show you how fast you can do U9, just because he's not the fastest, but that doesn't mean anything. If he's your favorite character, then you're going to want to play him anyways, right? And you can actually use this character in U9 right now. And I would actually say that, we're not going to show it off today, but the passive ability of this character makes you have increased movement speed if you touch lava. So if you're going to a fire elemental world, this guy is a force to be reckoned with, man, so long as you're touching the lava every 2 seconds, right? In either case, though, folks, thanks so much for watching. Very much appreciate it. Don't forget to like, share, favorite, and subscribe for more daily content. Links will be in the description to my merch store and Gawkbox, where you can actually donate to me for absolutely free. Sign or and stay epic, everybody.